Hey, what's up you guys? It's Jess and welcome back to my channel and to my kitchen. So I know I promised Halloween themed food this month and I just want to go ahead and apologize that this isn't the most like doesn't like scream Halloween, but it is a pumpkin recipe and I don't love pumpkin, but this recipe sounded good and I'll tell you why. But after last week and the macaroons, I wanted to take a little bit of a break from like sweets and difficult foods. Like I wanted to make this recipe from Caitlin Shoemaker. She is actually a recipe creator and vlogger here on YouTube and I love to watch her content. Her food always looks awesome. And I've tried a couple of her recipes in the past, but obviously not on camera. Today's video is going to be me attempting to make her one pot pumpkin pasta. I don't love pumpkin, but there is rosemary and sage, which I got from my garden, and you know, vegetable broth. It's more of a savory pumpkin recipe and it'll be like a creamy pasta. So I'm excited about that. It should be better than pumpkin spice lattes. But I wanted to make something that I could eat on more than one occasion instead of taking it to work. Like I could probably eat this for a few days. Usually I take my creations to work and share it with everyone, which is great, but sometimes it's good to just keep it all to yourself. So we're gonna go ahead and get started and I've already got the ingredients prepped behind me. I'll show you what I've got and it should be a pretty simple recipe. I'm trying to eat healthier. This seemed like a good recipe. It is relatively healthy. It's got good ingredients. It's pretty whole foods type food. If you like this video, make sure to go ahead and give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I make new videos every single week and you know, it's pretty fun here. You know, watching me cook alone in my kitchen. I also have plans for vlogs, like actual vlogs in the future. I'm working on it this week. It's just something that I wanna do. So I'm gonna do it. And yeah, let's just go ahead and jump right into this video. I'm hungry for lunch and I need to eat. So let's see what the ingredients are. I got this bonza chickpea elbow macaroni, 4 cups of vegetable broth. I use this, actually, I don't always use this one. I couldn't find the other brand, but I use bouillon cube. I find that that's a little bit cheaper than buying the cartons of stock. 3/4 cups of pumpkin puree. I have diced and minced, I have minced 2 shallots, which made me cry like a motherfucker. I have 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg and several chopped cloves of garlic. Fresh rosemary and sage from my garden. 3 tablespoons of cashew butter. We've got 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. So that's really all the ingredients and we're gonna throw it in a pot and let it cook. So I'll show you the process. Okay, so we're gonna get our pan on medium heat. Next, we're gonna pour some olive oil into the pan and get it nice and hot. Caitlin really makes a lot of oil-free recipes. So this recipe, I'm going to actually link it down below, but she does a lot of her recipes oil-free and oftentimes she just puts water in the pan to saute. So I prefer oil, but if that's something that your dietary needs are requiring, then it's super easy to saute stuff in water, according to Caitlin. So yeah, just FYI. So we're gonna saute the shallot. Add the herbs. And the garlic and nutmeg. I seriously love the smell of garlic and onion, and with the fresh sage and the rosemary, it smells really nice. Like, oh, it smells like fall, y'all. Now that the onions and the garlic have softened up a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and add the cashew butter and the pumpkin puree.
add the stock, the vegetable broth. Okay, time to add the pasta.
Okay, and that's pretty much it for the ingredients. Everything else basically, so that's pretty much it for the ingredients. I will let this cook and absorb all the water. You don't have to strain it or anything, she says in the recipe, that it'll absorb everything and get nice and thick. So I hope that it does. And I'm sure it will. And at the end, you pour in the tablespoon of lemon juice. And yeah, that's it. It's a really simple recipe. I'm excited to taste it. And now I am going to clean the dishes while it boils. Alright guys, so I already put it in a bowl. I don't have anything to make it look cute or Instagram worthy. Trust me when I say you need to go look at Caitlin's page, because especially her Instagram page, From My Bowl. She does really good food photography. Like, I don't think I'll ever be at that level. But one day maybe, that'd be sweet. I actually originally bought the light that I use for my YouTube videos for taking pictures of food, but I don't know, maybe with a little more research and learning on YouTube, I'll be able to take better photos of my food. But right now it just looks like a bowl of noodles, but it looks good. I mean, it looks like it's gonna taste good. I tasted it before I put the lemon in, and that was just because I needed to know if the noodles were finished. I didn't cook it nearly as long as her recipe says to. I don't know how long I cooked it, probably about like 6 or 8 minutes, and it got nice and thick. So, you know, just keep an eye on what you're cooking. That's my best advice for you. Don't always go off like the time that the recipe says, because it could be wrong based on what temperature you've got your stove set to, or your oven, or whatever. So that's just my little bit of advice. So here is, she's taking a tumble. Here's the finished product. It looks great, it smells good. It actually, I was kind of afraid that the noodles were gonna break apart and get too soft and mushy. But like I said, I made sure to turn the heat down before I let them overcook too much. So it thickened up nicely. It looks good. I'm excited that cashew butter was in there. It's still pretty hot, so that's why I've been talking a lot. But I'm gonna give it a try anyway. Blow it off. Honestly, you wouldn't be like, oh, that's a pumpkin recipe, if you didn't know what was in it. It's really creamy. It's got a little bit of that pumpkin flavor for sure. I mean, it's not gone completely, but I feel like with the amount of garlic and that shallot, oh my God, it's so savory. And those herbs, they really did give it like the essence of rosemary and sage, so it's very fall. These noodles are good too. They're not, you probably wouldn't tell, be able to tell that they're gluten-free. It's just super savory. I love it. I'm actually really happy with this. I'm trying to think what else to say, but honestly, I don't have a whole lot else to say besides it's really good and it was super easy. And I kind of live for that. The fresh herbs and the garlic and the onion. Superb. This is good. This is a great vegan dish. If you're not vegan, you should try it. I mean, Jesus. It's very good. It's almost like cheesy. So all in all, I would say that this recipe was a mega success. You go girl for developing recipes. It's not simple. I can get in the kitchen and throw things together, but as far as developing a recipe, I don't know if that's my forte. I would definitely give this recipe like a 9 out of 10. It's delicious. If you're not vegan, I think you'd like it. If you are vegan, I know you'll like it. If you're gluten-free, try it. It's great. These noodles are awesome. I really like them. I'm glad I gave them a shot. And yeah, if you guys like this video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because I do make new videos every single week. I'm gonna be throwing in, like I said at the beginning of the video, some vlogs, just like daily vlogs and doing stuff like that. I'm really excited to add all that into my channel because I really like to watch stuff like that. You know, if you don't watch it, but I really enjoy things like that, so I think I want to add that into my channel. And yeah, I hope to see you guys on the next one. I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I will catch you all on the next one. Happy Halloween. Bye.